If you are just focused on getting new revenue, getting new customers to grow your business online, then you're just like the 90% of businesses that are growing their business in the wrong way. This is probably gonna be the most important video that you are ever gonna watch on growing your business, increasing your sales, and getting more customers and clients in your business online than you can ever imagine. My name is Benson, and today I'm gonna be teaching you the three core revenue pillars that you must have in order to grow your business online. At the end of this video, I'm gonna be giving you the structures, the frameworks, and hundreds of ways that you can use to be able to increase your sales online. So at the end, you're gonna get everything you need to know about growing these three core revenue pillars. Now that you've focused on implementing more traffic and generating that to your website, and you've also been able to convert those into leads and subscribers, we're focusing on the third core way to grow your business online, which is how do we convert all that into revenue and sales for your business, and how do we acquire lifelong customers that continuously come back to shop at your business, buy your products and your services, and they want to do this on an ongoing basis. Now that we have this, if you do not focus on these three things, then I want you to go back and learn how to drive more traffic and also how to generate more leads and subscribers for your business. You want to make sure that these two pillars are extremely strong when they're supporting your business. Without these two, you cannot focus on generating more sales. Now, obviously, as a byproduct and as a result of having more traffic to your website and having more conversion to get more leads and building that community and indoctrinating them, you're gonna generate sales regardless, because those two are extremely strong foundations before we focus on amplifying your sales, which is what I'm gonna share with you right now. Now, the first thing you wanna know is that there are three core revenue pillars in increasing your sales online. The first pillar is your new revenue. This is what most businesses focus on. How do we get and acquire new customers to the business? How do we build that lifeline, that pipeline, or whatever word you want to use? People focus on the new revenue channel. They use paid media, they use organic traffic, they try to get new customers to buy. That's the first pillar, and it's an important one. But there's two more pillars that a lot of businesses miss. The second one is, how do you build more ascension revenue? Ascension revenue is people that are already your customers and clients, and you get them to get more of the products or services that are already there. They're gonna upgrade, they're gonna downgrade, they're gonna get all these different things, but they're your existing customers and clients. The third revenue pillar that's extremely important is your recurring revenue plus retention pillar. This is one of the things that you wanna implement into your business. These two are gonna be the most important ones, and the two that most businesses don't even focus on, or they ignore, or they don't even know that exist. So the goal of this is, how do we incorporate not just the new revenue, don't focus on just acquiring new people, how do we maximize the existing customers and clients that are in your business to increase your business online? Because this is how you're gonna build a sustainable business in the long term. Now, those three are based off the only three ways to increase your sales online. It's either gonna be new revenue, it's gonna be ascension revenue, or it's gonna be recurring revenue plus retention. So based on these three things, they are already channels of revenue for your business. What we wanna do in the first core step is identify for your business, what is the new revenue? What is the ascension revenue? And what is the existing recurring and retention revenue that's in your business? I want you to identify the traffic that's coming through, and I wanna identify the leads that are coming through. And then when they convert into sales, what are these three revenue pillars? How much are you getting from new revenue? How much are you getting from ascension? And how much are you getting from recurring revenue for your business? Once we identify those through the traffic, the leads, and also the conversions of sales, we want to focus on the next piece, which is, how much does it cost to acquire all of these three revenue channels? You literally want to start with this in a spreadsheet or a piece of paper if you have it, or you just sit down, you map out. The first thing is, here are my three revenue pillars. This is how much revenue you're making from these three. And what you might see is, you might not even have a pillar for reoccurring, or you might not even have ascension. That's fine. Most businesses don't focus on those things. You just wanna know that I'm gonna teach you how to incorporate those. But for now, identify what are the three revenue channels. Then what you wanna do is, you wanna focus on breaking them down by the traffic, number one, focusing on the leads, and then focusing on the sales, which is what you did at the top level. After that, what we wanna do is, how much does it cost to acquire a new customer? How much does it cost to acquire a recurring customer? How much does it cost to acquire an ascension customer? What you're gonna find is there's a different cost for each revenue pillar and each customer that you acquire. One is gonna be more expensive, and it's always the new customers that are the most expensive. The ones that you get to ascend and the ones that you get to recurring revenue are the ones that are the lowest and the highest value. Lowest cost, but highest value, which is why I want to implement these two into increasing your online sales through these two channels. Now, after you identify these things, you understand what is coming in and what is going out, we want to focus on moving into the next step, is how do we amplify this? There's a process for this. Let's go into it. So if you're in the physical product space, you're doing e-commerce, it's not just the ad spend that you're putting behind to acquire a customer, but you want to look at how much it costs to manufacture your product, how much it takes to fulfill the product with your team, how much is it for shipping the product. All these things calculate into the true cost of acquiring the customer and how much you're spending to build that revenue for new customers as well. At the same time, if you're doing a service, how much is it costing you to fulfill on the service for the customer or the client? You want to build that cost into the acquisition cost for that customer, but also look at breaking it down between the three revenue pillars. For example, let's say you are acquiring and spending ads on Facebook, on Google, on YouTube, on Instagram. All these four revenue channels, let's say, produce a different type of revenue and a different cost for new revenue, for reoccurring revenue, and ascension. You want to make sure that you break down these three revenue pillars based on how much you're spending on those social channels, for example, and how much revenue each customer is producing you from the social channels. Now, this might sound overwhelming, but I'm gonna simplify it for you in the next part. But make sure that you understand, once you break this down and once you see this, I want you to keep this statement in mind. This is gonna be super important for you to increase your sales online. Each customer that you generate from each channel is not worth the same thing. When you get one from one channel, it's gonna be worth more one time in the long term as well, reoccurring revenue and ascension revenue. So don't look at just the front end, but understand that each customer you generate, each conversion is not worth the same. It's all different values. And when you can identify which values are worth the most for your business, you're able to exponentially focus on this and amplify it even more. But let's look at the biggest companies on the planet, like Amazon.com. They're one of the largest e-commerce businesses in the world, and you can take a look at their site. They focus on all three revenue pillars as well. New revenue is very obvious. You go on Amazon.com, you can actually see the products. When someone searches any kind of product on Amazon, they can buy those new products. The second way you can see is they focus on ascension revenue. When you go on the page, you can see that they recommend what customers often buy with this product, with this book, whatever it is, they're recommending that. So they want to increase the average order value. They want you to get the best experience, but at the same time, they want to make sure that you're buying multiple different products whenever you go onto the cart. So they recommend complementary products, they recommend other people things that you can be able to consolidate in one thing, and they even focus on reoccurring revenue. Now, how do they do that? When you go on Amazon.com, one of the services that they've incorporated is Amazon Prime, or any Amazon membership that they have with Amazon TV. You can see that Amazon Prime gives you access for shipping, fast shipping, 1 to 2 days, or the same day delivery. They give you things like you're able to access Amazon Music, Amazon Movie, Amazon TVs. So you can go on and watch different shows. They really bundle that in, and that builds recurring revenue. It's almost like a membership that charges you every single month. And I've talked with a lot of Amazon customers, you're probably one too, that uses Amazon Prime and they love it. So that's how Amazon builds their recurring revenue, and they have hundreds of thousands of people that are on that membership, probably millions of people that are using it. Can you imagine? It's $29.95 or somewhere around there, and they've got hundreds of thousands of millions of people every single month that's building their recurring revenue, and all it is just offering a better experience, like a premium membership. The second thing is they're building the new and their ascension revenue all on Amazon.com. Once we've identified the three revenue pillars that you have and all the channels of traffic that's feeding into them and converting them into customers, then we want to identify what are the top three channels that are feeding into each revenue pillar. So for example, let's say you have new revenue right now, you're doing $100,000 a year. We want to break that down. We notice that Facebook is bringing in $20,000. We've noticed that YouTube is bringing in $50,000. We notice that Twitter is bringing in $5,000. We notice that Instagram is bringing in $10,000. So what we want to do once we separate these channels of revenue is we want to identify the top three channels that are producing the revenue. And then we don't want to amplify that. We want to make sure that we're doing more of what's working and then doing less of what's working, or cutting down completely and testing new different channels. Same thing for the reoccurring revenue, for the ascension revenue, you do the exact same thing. You calculate how much it's worth reoccurring wise from a Facebook customer. and also how much it's from ascension from a Facebook customer. Now, what's gonna be interesting is that it's not gonna be worth the same as I mentioned before. What you're gonna find is you might be acquiring customers, new customers from Facebook, that might be $10. And then when you find out the recurring revenue or the essential revenue, it's very, very low. So even though you're making a lot of money from new customers, it's not worth that much. Now, what's interesting, and let's say YouTube is costing you $50 to acquire a new customer, but they are sending over time, they're increasing their average order value, they're buying more products or services from you, and they stay longer with you. Their lifetime value is worth more to your business. Then even though the $50 cost of YouTube is worth a lot, it makes so much more sense to focus on YouTube because the recurring revenue and the ascension revenue is so much higher. So never take things at a first glance, but really understand what it is. So once we break this down, focus on the top three things that are revenue channels are making the most money, and then be able to amplify that, and then find the top three worst performing channels for each revenue pillar, and then slow it down or cut it away. The next thing that you can do once you've identified your own revenue pillars and the sources of traffic that you're going on to acquire customers, let's look at your competitors and how they're building their revenue and where they're spending their money. So what we want to do is we can actually see how much money your competitors are spending on advertising using two specific tools. On paid advertising, we can use a tool called What Runs Where. You can go on there, you actually get a very low cost membership to get and understand where are your customers running their advertising across different social channels, on Google, on Facebook, on Instagram. See the advertising and how much approximately that they're spending. It's not 100% accurate, but it gives you a picture of seeing what they're spending. So if you know, for example, your competitors are spending $50,000 on Facebook or $100,000 on Twitter or $10,000 on Google, then you'll know why are they spending so much money on this, what ads are they showing? So that gives you valuable insights into what you should be doing in terms of advertising for yourself. And also it gives you valuable data on where their most profitable channels are. Most likely if someone's spending $50,000, $100,000 on one channel and it's the dominating one from all the other ones, it means it's really working well for them. So that's why you should replicate it and focus on doing that as well. And then also seeing if they have all these top three channels, you do it for yourself if you're not doing it. And if they already are doing it, look at what are the other channels that they're doing that you're not focusing on. The second tool that you want to use is called SEM Rush. Now, SEM Rush is going to be the tool where you can actually enter your competitors. And same thing, you're going to be able to see their ads, how much they're spending on a specific channel, Google, Facebook, or YouTube, and actually be able to see the amount of ads that they're doing and how much ad spend. The third thing you're going to be able to do is also cross-reference between SEM Rush and also What Runs Where to see what is the aggregate, what's an average of both, because both of them are platforms that are taking data from different sources and they're combining them. But why you want to use both is you can get an average and an aggregate of both, so you can get the insights and be able to apply it and see which one is going to be more accurate, and then build a plan around that from your three new revenue pillars: the new, the ascension, and the recurring revenue pillar. These three core revenue pillars are really going to exponentially grow your business online, and it's how you increase your sales and build a long-term sustainable business. Now, well, you might say that the new revenue, the recurring revenue, and the ascension revenue, it sounds very complicated. Now, I just want to give you five core ways that you can use to build your ascension revenue and your recurring revenue. The first thing that you can do is you can find out what are the complementary products or services that you can add to your existing business. From the products and services you already sell, or if you don't have enough products, then focus on what are the complementary products that you can add. What services could you add? You can add consulting, you can add coaching, you can add a service where you're able to offer them a meal plan or different things that you can do. If let's say you have a supplement, what you can also do, you can add blender bottles. You can add different things like more supplements, or you can add supplements to different categories. There are so many complementary products and services you can add to your existing offering and lineup that it's almost what you want to do is focus on the core ones. All you need to do is have the right complementary products and services, and you'll be able to build your ascension and recurring revenue. The next thing you can do is three core things. Usually what happens with your consumers is there's a do-it-yourself option, there's a do-it-with-you option, and there's a done-for-you option. If you're able to break down your business, your services, or your products by these three things, you can add them right away. For example, do-it-yourself is things that you can offer products where they're focusing on just they buy it, and then they take it home, and then they implement it, and whether or not they get results, it's all up to them. Do-it-with-them is something like services. Let's say, for example, you consult with them, you walk them through the process of using your product or service. It's almost like a premium service in a sense. The third way you can do this is done for them. So you can offer a service where you literally give them the highest, best personalized service or best product and be able to actually add that in, whatever product they buy, whatever service, you give them the premium level and you make sure that they achieve the results that they want or they solve the problems. And people are willing to pay a premium for done for you because people are lazy, they don't want to do anything. So when you're able to offer an option where you get them the result or the problem without them having to do anything and you do it for them, then it's extremely powerful. It's why how consulting firms, how agencies make money, they help businesses grow and they do it the whole thing for them. They just get paid a monthly fee and then they focus on doing that. Third way you can do this is being able to add a premium product or a service to your existing lineup. There's always a percentage of your customers or clients that are willing to pay more for more service, for better engagements, for even more things that you can add value to their business and make things easier for them, save them time, save them money, and be able to just offer a premium quality experience and premium quality result and more engagement and more touch points with them. The next one is you take your product or your service and you break it down into different ways that people consume your product or your service. So for example, let's say you have a service where you're offering a very premium endpoint kind of service where it's very high touch point where you're having to just work with them very closely. What you can do is you can turn what you're doing there into a course or even a book, and you show that same way that you're doing, but except you're teaching them how to do it in a course, it doesn't take much of your time, and you lower it at a different price point. So you're able to capture more of the market share or more of the customers that aren't able to afford your expensive version, whatever price point that you're going for right now. Or let's say you have someone where it's in the middle, you wanna add a top premium part and you add a lower part that involves less of your time, less of your money, less of your resources. There's so many different ways you can move up and down and you can move left and right. The final thing that you can do is if you think that, hey, it's gonna take so much money, time, and resources to develop a ascension product or a recurring product or service for either or of those revenue channels, then what you can do is you can actually find partnerships with existing companies and websites that you can just basically partner up with. Take their product, become an affiliate, promote it to your unsold buyers or promote it to your existing buyers and find out how you can build ascension and recurring revenue. Test out those different things. This is actually one of the strategies I used for myself. I used it for my companies and different clients that I have. And it's done millions of dollars just by partnering with people that have existing products or services that are complementary for our target audience and we can add more value to them and be able to just cross promote each other, vice versa, right? You promote theirs and see if it's a good test before you commit the resources into it. And you can also promote your product or services to their list as well and then cross promote each other and be able to build each other up. Just going through the process that I just went through with you for understanding the new, the reoccurring, and the ascension revenue pillars and identifying the sources and the channels, the top three ones, how to build it into your business has made me and my clients' companies multi-millions of dollars. So what I want you to do is to focus on really understanding this and rewatching this, or what I want you to do as promised is go on to Benson.com, go to the Digital Marketing University. There's a link here to the exact post where I'm gonna walk you through step by step how to build new ascension and recurring revenue, 50 to 100 ways for each one, how to add this to your business. How do you incorporate this regardless of the industry that you're in, the business stage that you're at, the target audience that you're going for, or the product or service that you sell. There's ways to build all three revenue channels into your business. I'm gonna walk you through step-by-step how to do this in more detail on the expanded post here. Now, if you like this video, what I want you to do is three core things. I want you to comment below. I want you to let me know what is the product or service that you sell. And now I'm gonna let you know how to incorporate all three revenue pillars in your business. I'll give you feedback. I'll answer your questions. The next thing I want you to do is I want you to hit like on this video. Let me know you like this video, you're getting value from this. And I'm gonna make sure there's more videos that are gonna be coming out. It's gonna add more value to you and show you how to grow your business and increase your sales online. The third thing is there's gonna be a face that's gonna pop up here. I want you to hit that subscribe button because every single week there's gonna be videos like this teaching you how to grow your business online through digital marketing. So thanks for watching the video and I'll see you in the next one.